Hello everyone, this is Revan from Digi Integrative. Welcome to Tech News episode 246. Steve Versey from Cornwall lost his eye when he was just a child, now an engineer in his 40s. He became the first person in the world to receive a 3D printed eye on Thursday after a surgery at Mansfield High Hospital in London. The new eye is more realistic than exciting prosthetics and can be implanted without the usual invasive process of molding out an eye socket. The digitally created eye takes half the time to produce compared to existing hand painting methods. The procedure includes a scan of the patient's eye, following which a 3D model further eye socket is mapped out to the printer. Their good eye is also scanned to ensure the precise match. A 3D printer in Germany then prints the eye in just under 2.5 hours. World's first floating city to set sail in South Korea by 2025. The floating city will be built in such a way that it will rise along with the sea level and it will be flood-proof. FoldApp has partnered with Niantic to develop an AR game that lets you mine Bitcoin. Fold sees the AR Bitcoin mining game as a part of its own multiverse. The new AR experience will be an extension of the FoldApp that already allows users to earn Bitcoin. India's mobile gaming sector will grow from $1.5 billion of revenue in 2020 to $5 billion by 2025. While India's gaming company initially monetized through in-game advertising, 80% of the $1.5 billion generated by mobile gaming in 2020 came from in-app purchases and real money game spends. There are now over 300 million gamers in India, and revenue across all gaming devices reached over $1.8 billion in 2020, which is up to 500% from 2016. A couple of IPL teams are not happy with the BCCI over its decision to ban any sponsorship deals with the cryptocurrency exchanges. The board doesn't want the franchisees to strike a commercial deal with the exchanges till the time the Indian government brings a regulation in place for the sector. Two franchisees revealed that they have been approached by major cryptocurrency exchanges over sponsorship deals ahead of IPL 2022. However, the negotiation has to be stalled after BCCI dictated over crypto. The board has asked all teams and the media right holders to avoid signing any sponsorship deals with the crypto exchanges. Xiaomi India has announced a Black Friday sale bringing along attractive offers nearly across its entire portfolio. The sale will be going live on MI.com, Flipkart and Amazon, MI Home and all other offline partners. It commenced on November 25th and will last until November 30th. A Redmi G series laptop battery has been spotted on BIS certification agency's website. The battery has been listed under the Poco brand name, suggesting the launch of a Poco laptop. Poco has already tested the arrival of several AIoT devices in 2022. Realme GT 2 Pro 5G has posted a record-breaking score on AnTuTu, becoming the first smartphone to breach the 1 million mark. The smartphone is speculated to feature the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor. It will become the first device from Realme to get the latest Snapdragon chipset from Qualcomm when it launches in early 2022. South Korean media claims that Samsung won't be releasing any Galaxy Note devices in 2022. The report further says that Samsung is putting an end to the Galaxy Note 20 production by the end of this year. Samsung Galaxy S22 Ultra could be the spiritual successor to the Galaxy Note 20. Samsung Galaxy A13 4G enters into production of the Greater Noida factory. Samsung Galaxy A13 4G will come with a plastic rear panel. The smartphone will have a quad rear camera setup. Apple is expected to unveil its first augmented reality headset in quarter 4 of 2022. The augmented reality headset will come with two chips, one of them said to be as powerful as M1. The AR headset will be a standalone product instead of being an iPhone-linked accessory. MediaTek Dimensity 9000 chipset will power the Redmi K50 gaming smartphone. Other specifications include a punch-hole display with a high refresh rate, optical in-display fingerprint sensor, and a 64-megapixel camera, and comes with a 5000mAh battery. The Redmi K50 gaming could debut as a Poco F4 GT in India and other regions. TechnoSpark 8S new variant is priced at ₹10,999 in India. It will be available via Amazon India and comes in three color options. Buyers will get free one-time screen replacement with the smartphone. Infinix Note 11 and Infinix Note 11 Pro smartphones were unveiled by Infinix in October. The company later announced that the device will be launched in India earlier this month. Company launched the another smartphone in this Note 11 series, which is called as Infinix Note 11S. And now Infinix India CEO has teased the India launch of Infinix Note 11 and Infinix Note 11S retail boxes along with the caption. And we can expect that these smartphones will be a gaming smartphone. PUBG New State will start getting exclusive content for gamers in India. The South Korean publisher has partnered with Sony Music India to bring the song Bad Boy Bad Girl by pop singer Badshah to the Battle Royale game. It is said to be the first of many upcoming collaboration of Indian pop music with PUBG New State. Krafton has also kicked off the dance challenge and announced a launch of a web series titled New State Chronicles to enhance user engagement on the new game. A bug in PUBG New State allowed some players to unintentionally claim certain in-game items. These players were temporarily blocked for accessing PUBG New State. PUBG New State went through an emergency update to fix the issue and restore player accounts. Spotify is in process of testing a TikTok-style video feed that allows video clips of songs that are being played in a full-screen format. According to reports, this feature was first spotted by Chris Messina, who tweeted about and shared a video of the Spotify feed with the new format. Messina described the feature as a paid-down version of the TikTok-style music feed. Currently, Spotify is testing this feature on beta in its iOS application.
Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow DigiIntegrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.